to start our restorative class this morning.
If your right leg is in front, please walk your hands off to the left.
your right simple, reach through your right arm, look ahead, find this beauty, this space into the waist and the lower back. You can gaze down once you see how it goes and notice, feel that space into the waist. One more, let that exhale be a little further extension, a little more spider walking of the hands. And then bring the hands back to center. Slowly walk the hands back up towards the shins. Sit up tall. We're going to take a side bend next. Inhale, reach up your arms. Bring your right hand down. I want to take the left arm and reach it up and over. Take an inhale. Now as you exhale, bend your right arm. Reach the left fingertips further. And start to keep that extension to the left side. Your sit bones are grounded, take a full inhale, and your exhale is reaching, extending, find that space. I love the beauty of a side stretch. We're very boxy in our movements in the day, and just the side stretch reminds us that we can have all this extra space and all this extra movement and range. Come all the way back up. You may even feel like you're sitting crooked for a moment after you sit up. Let's switch which leg is in front and do the other side. Breathe in, reach arms up. Left hand down, lean to the left, reach with your right arm. Root through your right sit bone, extend to the fingertips. I like to bend the base arm. You might slide it out, totally up to you. Keep your sit bone grounded. My right sit bone's grounded because my right arm's on top. Keep reaching like you're trying to grab something or somebody you love with those top fingertips. One more breath here. Come all the way back up. Close your eyes for a moment and just feel the side waist, feel the lower back. Such a nice movement. All right, so the next one that we're gonna do, we're gonna need one of your towels. So you'll lean forward, coming off your towel, have it folded similar to something like this. And we're going to take a really great stretch. This is actually from a joint frame series for your your lower back. So one leg's going to be bent forward in the front, and the other leg's going to go behind you. And turn to the side just for a moment so you can see the angle. So one leg behind, one leg in front. Now, for me, I feel pretty crooked when I don't use a blanket here or a towel. So the leg that's in front, the heavier sit bone, if you will, we're gonna boost it. So I'm just gonna take my towel, bring it underneath, right underneath my right sit bone still, so I have this nice space happening between my left sit bone and the earth. And really what we're looking for with this extra height is to make our hips feel more even, but also to give this left sit bone the ability to descend down as we get some more range. So with right sit bone boosted with your towel, make sure it feels comfortable. I'm just kind of adjusting mine as well. Okay, so hands are going to be on, keep your right hand off to the side like a kickstand. What we're going to do is roll the left thigh in. So I actually want you to use your left hand and roll the thigh inward. So we're rolling the thigh inward and then turning to the right. When you breathe out next, I want you to use your hand. So I'm using my hand all the time and I'm pressing down and rooting this left sit bone towards the earth. Mine won't touch yours. Mine is not touching this time. So we're going to take this several times. So breathe in, sit kind of proud to the right, like your chest lifts up a little bit, your thigh rolls in, and exhale, bring it back down. Now we're going to take about 15 of these. On your own, maybe you find today as you move through practice that you find certain postures that we do today feel really good. You can take these longer. This one's really nicely done until it feels free. It's the best way I can think of explaining it, because right now it may feel kind of clunky or not very smooth in the movement. Let this be a smooth movement, and you'll feel after doing it several times, and usually for several minutes, that you will be able to get some more fluidity here. This is really great for if you tend to get asymmetrical discomfort in your lower back. This is great for evening, kind of making that Switch out the legs. Boost your sit bone with your towel or blanket on the left side. Left leg is forward, right leg is bent behind. Make sure you feel comfortable in the height of your blanket. You can always change it or towel, that is. Okay, so on this one, left hand goes out to the side just to support you. We're gonna roll the thigh in. Use your hand, actually roll the thigh bone forward. And then as you breathe out, you're gonna sink it back down. Breathe in, turn towards your left thigh, and breathe out, bring it down. Your eyes can be open or closed. Just find this nice movement. And notice the difference between each leg. Notice if you start to feel more fluidity.
Hearing yourself back to the wall.
When you do come back up, you'll pause the back of the head against the wall so you can really get all the benefits. You might, if you get dizzy, keep your eyes open. Keep your breath strong as you do this. We're going to do this together. Since you won't be able to look up at the camera, count to 1 minute in your head as you roll down. And when you come up, it'll be about 30 seconds. So when you're ready, begin. As slow as you can, begin to peel the back of the skull off the mat, pardon me, off the wall. Your sit bones or part of your buttocks touching the wall as you're folded all the way forward. Take a few breaths here in this fold. To protect your lower back, bend your knees slightly. Come up, trying to take at least 30 seconds. If you find this is uncomfortable in your lower back, then please move faster to the stage where it does not hurt. Slowly adhere your lower back, your sacrum, depending on how your back is shaped, your shoulder blades.
Wherever it stops, I want you to pause and take a deep breath out, and just like the beginning.
back, we keep the nails connected the whole time, back up and over. Turn your palms face down, fingertips touching the ground, and then close all the way back up. I'll show you again, and so this will be timed for 3 minutes on each side. So arm up and over, palm turns up, maybe you stay here. If your shoulder is not making a clicking sound or is not painful, then keep opening to your range. Take a breath out and reach through the fingers. You're trying to get that left side scapula closer to the earth, maybe even touching. Close back up, nails touch. And I will time this one. We're gonna take this for 3 minutes. The key is to keep your fingertips or your fingernails connected the whole time. Once you get the movement, you may choose to close your eyes. This is very soothing. This is a therapeutic exercise for your shoulders, so if your range is inhibited and maybe you're finding yourself stopping maybe right above the head, that's okay. Close back up and just keep working to that range. You'll find that eventually you'll get more. Maybe it's a half an inch, maybe an inch. And this is one I would recommend doing every day, especially if you're rehabbing the shoulder or you tend to work at a computer or have poor posture a lot in the day. Really, we all do. Devicing, driving, taking care of kids. Got 2 more minutes on the same arm. Thank you. to your opposite side that you were a moment ago.
Make sure you have enough space above you, and I've got a lot of stuff here.
Start the same action that you did before. Limbs to your head is comfortable. You have a nice range above you. Stack your knees again. Take this top arm, reach it all the way up and over. Stopping where it begins to be uncomfortable. And then if you have full range, again, you continue to turn the palm to face up and then reach all the way out. Take a few breaths, especially this first one, and just reach through the fingertips. If this feels odd in your lower back and it just didn't mind, that means that it wasn't aligned correctly. So you can, often the hips are either too far forward or too far back. I'm going to try to align them, the hips, with this inner part of your upper arm. And then closing all the way back up. Try to keep your fingertips connected the whole time. Bend the elbow if you need it. So we're here for 3 minutes. The back of the nails touch when the arms over the head, palms, fingertips turn down. Yes. So just start this movement. You might choose to close the eye, that's very soothing. This tactile work the whole time.
that triangle shape going in the base of your back. It feels a little heavier because you allow the chest to open up and wait for the back. We have this nice twist that lengthen out the belly. Maybe you notice this in your lower back. Hear your breath. Notice the weight of the back of the knuckles, the backs of the hands. Okay, next we're going to roll to the side and move this blanket. We're not going to need any blankets for this next one. I'll show you lying down and I'll show you standing up the shape. Many of you might be familiar with this one. This is called banana pose. I'm going to scoot back so I'm actually on my mat. So you're going to lay all the way back. The arms will reach up and over your head. I want you to take your left leg to the left side of your mat. Cross your right leg over. Start to lean your torso to the left by kind of arching or shimmying your right rib cage to the right. So legs are to the left as well as arms. I'm going to stand up just to show you what it would look like if I was not laying down. So it's kind of this shape. So as if you were making a banana shape, right? Banana pose. So with your left leg to the left, your right leg on top, arch your rib cage to the right. And at first, this one I feel is very deceiving. You may feel like there's not a lot going on. But this is a beautiful side stretch again. So even though we're arched to, our ribs are working to the right, our arms and legs are to the left, keep your legs as they are, but you might experiment with what leg feels better on top. I actually prefer left leg on top of right because it roots my right thigh bone back further. I get a really beautiful stretch into the psoas on the right side, but that is personal preference. So you get to decide which one feels best for you. You might feel this deep into the front side of your belly. Begin to center ourselves again, uncross the legs, kind of shimmy yourself back to center, uncross the arms. Now let the arms and legs just go down, arms along your sides, legs straight, and start to observe the difference. You should feel that the right side leg is likely feels longer here, while the right side of your waist feels longer as well. Maybe that right side scapula is closer to the earth. Let's try the other side. Take your right leg off to the right. Left leg crosses on top, arms over your head. Now start to move your rib cage to the left. So you're banana shaping or even C shaping to the right. If this is too much for your top shoulder, you can take one of your blankets and place it underneath. If it's really too much for it, you can have it wherever it feels comfortable, off to the side or down along your body. So first find the banana shape Next, we're going to take a tree frog, which you will need your blanket or your towels for. This is going to become a support for your inner knee and your inner ankle. So I'm going to unroll my towel here, place it off to the side, enough that would be the length to from the inner knee to the inner heel. You may choose to take your second towel to the top if you'd like to have a blanket here. I don't normally, but I will show you that, or know that that's an option. So this one is done on our belly. I'm going to show laying down, and I'll stand up showing the shape list in case it's hard to see there. So the arms are going to be kind of like a goalpost. You're going to bring your right knee up and off to the side, so your inner knee, inner heel are stacked, like you're in a half split here. Now, if you tend to have kind of bony hips, or maybe thinner, this might be hurting your left side hip bone, like you're kind of pressing in. If it is, you can use your other towel for that. So a few options. Could just be here, one side of the head down, arms to the goalpost, adjust so your chest feels comfortable here. You could also use a blanket if you prefer. Depends on what feels good for you. Sometimes I like to take the edge of a blanket and then fold it up enough that I can just rest my forehead. So my nose is hanging off, it has room, and I prefer to have my head straight down. These are personal preferences and options for you. This one's really great for releasing psoas for, this is also a nice one for your SI and lower back, inner thigh and groin as well. So as you sit up here, I'm gonna stand up for a moment so you might need to see that the shape looks something like this on the ground. One leg is out to the side, inner knee, inner ankle, and try to have your knee, you know, in line with the hip as best you can. If this one's uncomfortable, pad the areas that need padding for you. And we're gonna hold this for a few minutes on each side. What I like to notice when I get into this one is how the knee feels at first and how the inner ankle feels. Use your breath, soften into the inner thigh, let the inner knee rest. You'll feel as you're here longer that the knee will get a little heavier, inner ankle a little lighter. Notice your belly breath. Your belly presses out into the earth. This is great for also releasing muscles into the lower back. The right side of your belly getting a little softer, the knee feeling a little heavier. Give about a minute more in the shape. abs are comfortable.
Arms like a goalpost. Inner knee, inner ankle supported by your towel. Adjust so your chest feels good. Let your eyes close. Use this time to feel how your breath moves you, how the belly feels as it presses down to the mat.
After your third.